What's it like to play the Nintendo Entertainment System? The Nintendo Entertainment System. Now you're playing with power.
Alright, so before I dive into how this was all put together, I want to share some ground rules I had for this build. Number 1. Use original Nintendo hardware and software. No Raspberry Pis or ROMs here. I already did that with my Cement Thwomp build, and you can check that out in the link above. I really liked the idea and the novelty of putting an NES inside of another NES, and I just could not pass that up. Rule number 2. Do no harm. I didn't want to alter, damage, or destroy functional Nintendo hardware, especially an old and beloved retro system such as the NES, with an ever-increasing rarity. I sourced my NES console from eBay, but I had a hard time finding a legit one broken enough for me to tear apart and use. I ended up giving in to my geek Hippocratic Oath, and I was able to fix the first two with a brand new edge connector and a bit of soldering. So by the end of this build, there were more working NES consoles in the universe than when I started, so I count that as a win. Everything in this build conveniently runs off of 5 volts, powered by 18 650 batteries. I tried just using an off-the-shelf portable power bank, but having never built a battery pack like this before, I kind of wanted to give it a shot. Then I covered the ends up with some liquid electrical tape to prevent short-circuiting. And here I'm just soldering up the charge controller for the battery pack. And giving it a test. And it works. Here I'm disassembling the pocket projector in order to get to the internal buttons here. Marking the volume up, volume down, and power on buttons. And here I'm carefully removing this foil circle, which is actually the button itself. So when you push that button, it provides a short between the outer ring and the central circle here that I'm very carefully putting solder on. By putting some additional wire on those contact points, I can put the switch anywhere I'd like on the outside of the unit. We'll be right back. Hey, thanks for checking out this build. I hope you enjoyed it and it inspires you to get out into the shop and tinker around with some stuff. It was a lot of fun to work on, and I was glad to finally play around with some projectors and wireless charging in a project. I have some ideas for version 2, so if you have any thoughts on this, feel free to post them below, and I'll see you on the next video.